Hello, guys. Let's talk about the three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. We are going to use the example of water in this case. So solid water is just simply ice. We have liquid water. That's the type of liquid that we drink, right? And then we have water vapor. Now, if you look at these three pictures here of the water molecules in the three different states, you can see that in all three cases, we are going to have the same types of molecules, H2O molecules. The oxygen atoms are these red spheres right there, and the hydrogen atoms are these white spheres. So since we have one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms, the formula is H2O. Now, let's talk about the vapor phase. So gases, they're actually pretty far away from each other. So they just zoom around really, really fast. And due to that, they actually have no fixed volume or shape. On top of that, they will uniformly fill their container. And because the water molecules in a vapor phase, they are so far away from each other, you can compress them up to a high extent. All right, let's take a look at liquids. So in case of liquids, we are going to have a distinct volume, which is going to be independent of the container, okay? However, water or other liquids will assume the shape of the portion of the container. Now, how about solids? So solid water molecules in ice, they're very, very close to each other, and they are still moving, but to a very, very small extent. What happens to them? So in case of solids, we are going to have a definite shape and a definite volume. How about compressibility? So both solids and liquids, because we have so many molecules and they are relatively close to each other, in case of liquid, they can still pass each other, but it's a lot of them, it's crowded there. So they are not going to be compressible to any appreciable extent. And we are going to call the solid and the liquid phases the condensed states of matter. Now, what are the different properties of matter? We can classify the properties of matter as intensive and extensive properties. Intensive properties are independent of the amount of the substance. Extensive properties depend on the amount of the substance. Let's take a look at an example. Let's look at some apples. So what is the independent of the amount of the substance property that you can observe on these apples? Can you tell me anything about their smell, about their color? You can, right? So we can see, doesn't matter if we have two apples or we have way more than two apples, we can see that the color is going to be red. However, the mass, if you only have two apples, is going to be significantly smaller compared to this case when you have a bunch of apples, okay? So mass is going to be an extensive property. It depends on the amount of the substance. And color is going to be an intensive property, which is independent of the amount of substance. We can also classify the properties of matter as chemical and physical properties. So physical properties are color, odor, density, melting point, boiling point, and hardness, and so on. So to observe physical properties, you actually do not have to change the substance you are observing into a different substance. However, in case of chemical properties, we are going to observe those only when the substance is changed into another substance. And a good example of that is flammability. And that is my favorite example. All right. So we have intensive and extensive properties and chemical and physical properties. Now, let's look at the types of changes that matter can undergo. So we are going to have physical changes and chemical changes. In case of physical changes, we are not going to change the composition of the substance. So at the beginning of the change and at the end of the change, we are going to see the same type of molecule. However, in case of chemical changes, we are going to result in a new substance. So let's take a look at an example for a physical change. Let's take liquid water. What happens when you vaporize liquid water? You just boil it, right? Will you get the same type of water molecules? Yes, you will. The only difference is that the water molecules in case of water vapor are going to be way further away from each other compared to the liquid water when they are really, really crowded together. So in this case, due to the change, you did not change the composition of the substance. You still have H2O on both sides at the beginning and at the end of the change. Now, how about chemical changes? Well, let's take a look at an example. Let's take hydrogen molecules, H2, okay, and O2. Now, what happens when they react in a combustion reaction? So we are expecting to get a new substance, right? Because this is a chemical change. And indeed, as a result of a combustion reaction, we are going to get water molecules. Just simply from H2 plus O2, you are going to get H2O. So first day of classes is always blowing up hydrogen balloons. That is my favorite demonstration. And I actually do it also on the last day of classes just because it's really fun. So I'm actually going to cut in here one of those videos that I did during class. I hope you will enjoy it. And I hope this makes sense. See you in the next video.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.